What happened today? 1. The number of deaths in China's central Hubei province from a coronavirus outbreak rose by 93 to 1,789 as of Monday, the province's health commission said on its website. 2. The number of new coronavirus infections in mainland China fell below 2,000 for the first time since January, Chinese health officials said. 3. Russia said that plans by the United States to deploy weapons in space would deal an irreversible blow to the current security balance in space. 4. Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov said after meeting U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo last week that he had felt a more constructive approach from Washington when it came to the U.S.-Russia strategic dialogue. 5. The Syrian army said it had taken full control of dozens of towns in Aleppo's northwestern countryside and it would press on with its campaign to wipe out militant groups, wherever they are found. 6. Syrian President Bashar al-Assad said that his forces' rapid recent gains in their Russian-backed military offensive presaged the eventual defeat of the 9-year insurgency that sought to oust him from power. 7. A British lawmaker, who chairs an all-party group on Kashmir, has been denied entry to India after she criticized the government's decision to strip the disputed Himalayan region of its constitutional autonomy. 8. A high-profile local Taliban figure who announced and justified the 2012 attack on teenage Nobel laureate Malala Yousafzai has escaped detention, Pakistan's interior minister confirmed. 9. Lebanese Prime Minister Hassan Diab, who is getting the cold shoulder from Gulf Arab states, met Iran's parliament speaker, the first senior foreign official to visit since Diab's government took office. 10. Venezuela said it would suspend TAP Air Portugal flights into and out of the country for 90 days, accusing the carrier of allowing opposition leader Juan Guaido's uncle to bring explosives onto a flight to Caracas last week. 11. Australia's New South Wales state said that it will ease water restrictions after a deluge of rains filled dams across the country's east coast to their highest levels in more than 2 years. 12. The Trump administration is considering changing U.S. regulations to allow it to block shipments of chips to Huawei technologies from companies such as Taiwan's TSMC, the world's largest contract chipmaker. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more What Happened Today videos.